before.
Welcome to Armchair Directors. I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
And we have a turd alert for you today.
But this is a different type of turd alert.
A literal turd alert.
Human fecal matter.
Because we are taking a look at Jackass 3D, the pinnacle of 3D entertainment.
Give me a sec here.
Ooh. Okay, I'm good.
And if you go see this movie, you're going to do that at least three or four times.
Yeah. Whew. Okay, so Jackass. I'm gonna kick it off by saying if you haven't seen any Jackass ever, probably not the best way to introduce yourself, because 3D really does make everything more intense.
It certainly does. So if you do have a weak stomach, there is a lot of disgusting stuff thrown right into your face.
Literally, sick, twisted, evil, perverted, insane, hilarious.
I was gonna say
outrageous.
your IQ will drop, but you will laugh for 90 minutes straight.
Yeah. So the ideal viewing conditions, I would say, go out with some friends and just have a night out of being stupid idiots. Guys, don't bring your wives.
No.
Or your girlfriends.
No.
You know, and if there's some girls out there who are like, I can handle it, be my guest and let me know what you thought of it, because I warned you.
Yeah, for sure. But, you know, they don't really break the mold here. So if you already know what Jackass is about, Johnny Knoxville and his dumb buddies do stupid and or disgusting stunts. And they are hilarious. Lots of bodily harm. Lots of people getting kicked in the balls. Yep. People getting hurt.
Peed on.
And it's all still funny.
Pooped on, yeah. The only other Jackass I'd ever seen, I've heard of it, but I saw the first one in theater. And it was raunch. It was really raunchy. I laughed my ass off, saw it with some friends. And then I skipped the second one because, you know, I went, you know what, I'm okay.
Yeah, you're good.
And then the third one came out and the whole 3D gimmick kind of suckered me in. I'm like, well, this might be so bad it's good. And apparently there's another one coming out in January because they had extra footage.
Right.
So then they're going to shoot some more footage and just release another one. I think that's going to be too soon for me.
I think that is pushing their luck, because I think the reason the Jackass 3D works so well is that absence makes the heart grow fonder.
Yeah, exactly. And it also helps the bones heal.
Yeah. So, like, if it had come out, you know, a year after Jackass 2, I don't think it would have done nearly as well at the box office or had as many people wanting to see it. But since it's been so many years, you know, there hasn't been a good kick in the balls comedy. Mm-hmm. So it's nice to go and see something totally stupid, and especially 3D Jackass, which the first two were mostly shot on mini DV, so they looked horrible. And now it's one of the first major movies, you know, shot with the Avatar camera system.
It's
like, really? But some of the stunts are even funnier because stuff is flying out at you.
The jet ski, one of the first stunts, is a really great use of it coming right at you.
Yeah. The high five.
The high five, the Rocky with the water.
Yeah.
Again, it's that subtle use of 3D, which I really love. And it's just kind of funny to see this movie and Saw 3D being shot in 3D, and it's really making 3D not a big deal for me anymore.
Uh-huh.
Especially like a guy in this movie, their cameraman pukes on his 3D camera.
That part, well, especially because I was like, I want that camera, don't puke on it. Like, Lance Bangs, I'm gonna kill you. I want that camera.
It's gonna probably make you sick. Like, I think I have a cast iron stomach, and I had to turn away quite a few times nearing the end of it, because my quota, my tolerance of all this had just reached the end.
Now, it also didn't help that when we happened to see it, someone had brought stink bombs to the theater.
Yes.
And so while the stuff on screen was gag inducing, the fact that as I was watching it, the theater absolutely reeked during that last 20 minutes, I literally almost puked.
Yeah, that was pretty scary.
It was disgusting. So if you were the idiot who did that, I hate you.
And if the theaters are doing that, we hate you, because yeah. that really is not the way to make someone more drawn into a setting.
But so that's not Jackass 3D's fault, but basically, bottom line still, if you like stupid humor and have a strong stomach, Jackass 3D will make you laugh. And I think that brings us probably to best part.
Worst part.
Best part.
Best part.
Best part.
Best part.
Would have to be the cast.
I gotta go with the tank sequence.
The special effects.
The final 10 minutes of the movie.
Man in suit.
Man in suit! So that's the best part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Love story with Jessica Biel.
Cheap sounding canned.
Michelle Rodriguez.
Jennifer Aniston.
The entire movie. So I'm gonna start by saying the best part. The opening and the closing scenes that are really well orchestrated set up 3D sequences.
Yeah, those aren't shot, you know, bare knuckle, low budget type of prank, right. Reality prank type of show. Those are with shot with really nice sets.
Yeah, on a soundstage.
High production value.
Yeah, like lots of explosives.
And slow motion.
Really well choreographed things. The slow motion opening is absolutely hilarious. Mm-hmm. And just having, you know, Wee Man fly at you in 3D, dildos flying through the air, like crazy stuff in 3D that just is absolutely hilarious. So that, along with the stunt called the Rocky that they keep bringing back, that gag, that's my best part, hands down. Mostly because they use such great use of the 3D technology. Mm-hmm. Worst part? It's fairly easy to find a worst part, I guess, with this movie. Mm-hmm. The heavy reliance on poo. Definitely would probably be up there with the worst part, the poo and the pee, and anything that's not, the physical stunts work so much better than the gross out ones do. Mm-hmm. There's a couple of the gross out ones that are funny, but a lot of the time the gross out ones is just them all standing around laughing and very little is going on except people gagging or wanting to puke. So the stunts are great, but the gross out stuff, not so much. Mm-hmm. And your worst part?
I'm going to change things up here and do worst part, worst part. So worst part, the poo cocktail supreme, where they put Steve-O in a porta potty attached to a bungee, and Steve-O has the phobia of bungee and porta potties and poo. So they launch him in the air and he bounces up and down and up and down and up and down.
And just, in 3D, it's just swirling around
you. Everywhere. It's everywhere. And worst part, the volcano eruption.
That's got to be the worst part for sure.
Oof. So, yeah, if you want a dumb night out, and if you enjoy trying to make yourself sick, hey, if you're the type of person who drinks until, you know, you find your head in a toilet, go and see Jackass, because that's pretty much the same feeling you're going to get watching this, but probably a little more fun.
You're going to have fun while you're watching it, and later you will hate yourself for being so entertained.
I felt a little nauseous. Yeah, I thought it was a blast. I laughed quite a few times, but I was nauseous for 2 or 3 days after. So it does linger with you.
And if that's not a recommendation, I don't know what is.
Exactly. So don't try any of that at home, please. Thanks for watching, and until next time,
enjoy the show.
First man you're